In today's video, I have some updates for you in regards to monkeypox and the eyes. A common symptom of monkeypox is the characteristic rash that's like pimples or blisters that often affects the face. And if you have these blisters on the face, they can get onto the eyelids and potentially in the eye. And this, unfortunately, could lead to some nasty consequences. So in this video, we're gonna break down what the scientific literature says about how monkeypox can affect the eyes, who you may then wanna talk to if this develops, and then possible treatment options if monkeypox happens to get in the eye. So smash that like button and let's take a look. Hey, what's up? Dr. Joseph Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show. If you like learning about eye health and eyesight from a board-certified, fellowship-trained doctor of optometry, then make sure to hit the subscribe button and join us here for all of our content about eye health. Now, in June 2022, the World Health Organization did declare monkeypox as a world health emergency due to the increased case numbers that were appearing up in several countries, including the United States. And just more recently, you may have heard that the states of California, including New York and Illinois, have all declared states of emergency over the rising cases of the disease. Now, just for a quick review, monkeypox is part of the pox family of viruses that includes cowpox, camelpox, mousepox, and smallpox, although thankfully it's not as contagious or as deadly as that. Referring to the CDC website, the common symptoms include fever, headache, body aches and chills, swollen lymph nodes, exhaustion, and respiratory symptoms. And the swollen lymph node part is actually very important when somebody's assessing the eye, and we'll get into that in a little bit. But the most frequent symptom that people often experience is that of this blister-like rash that is often painful and itchy, with this rash often showing up in the face, trunk, and extremities, and may even show up on the anal genital regions. Now, monkeypox is known to be transmitted through broken skin, droplets, and bodily fluids, with sexual activity being a likely route of transmission and may increase the risk of this. Okay, so how does monkeypox affect the eyes? Well, like we said, if you have a monkeypox rash, these blisters, these large pimple boils or pox developing on your skin, if they're developing on the face, they could get on the eyelids, and if they get into the eye, then that can be affected. Now, digging into the published research, the most frequently reported sign and symptom of monkeypox on the eyes is that of conjunctivitis, which, if you've never heard that term, it's just the medical term for pink eye. Now, I know a lot of people come to me thinking pink eye is always caused by a bacteria or somebody like farting on your pillow or something.
I farted on Jason's pillow as a practical joke. He farted on Jonah's thinking it was mine, and then eventually pink-eyed my pillow.
But in reality, most cases of pink eye are in fact caused by viruses, just as in this case with monkeypox. Now, if you were a loved one who was to get monkeypox, the most frequent kind of symptoms you would experience is a red, puffy, swollen, irritated eye. You would likely be weeping a lot of tears, and potentially it could be painful, even causing blurred vision. Now, in the worst case scenario, is knowing that these rash lesions on your skin can ulcerate, so can the lesions that develop on the eye, and that could lead to conjunctival ulcers as well as even corneal ulcers, with the conjunctival ulcers being on the clear membrane on the white part of the eye, and then the corneal ulcers being the corneas that front window to the eye, that can lead to more serious problems. Being that corneal ulcers can leave scars leading to permanent vision loss, and then if something terrible was to happen, like a bacterial infection of those opened ulcers or wounds on the eye, then that can lead to scarring, perforation, and potential worse infections or loss of that eye. Now, again, I've been reading a lot of the research on this, and it looks like the percentage of people who do get pink eye in the case of monkeypox is about as high as 25%, with another reported case of about up to about 20% of people. And thankfully, for most of these cases, it doesn't look like serious consequences causing vision loss and blindness is very common. However, I did find one reported case of a patient who had a perforated cornea that eventually needed a corneal transplant. Now, what should you do or who should you see if you or a loved one does get monkeypox and it's affecting the eye? I do think it would be in your best interest to consult a local eye care professional, either a board certified doctor of optometry or ophthalmologist, someone who has good experience with anterior surface disease. As I was mentioning, there's many bacteria and viruses that can cause pink eye that can look very similar to this. As I was mentioning with monkeypox, checking the lymph nodes is very important and is something I always have to check for when I see a patient with pink eye, because there's also a nasty virus called adenovirus, which can cause swollen lymph nodes and may appear very similar to the way monkeypox appears on the eye. As far as treatment goes for monkeypox and how monkeypox affects the eye, for most cases of monkeypox, thankfully, it is self-limiting, resolving in just a matter of 2 to 4 weeks. So most care for monkeypox is supportive in nature, including treating the conjunctivitis or pink eye. So no matter what, most eye doctors are likely going to recommend that their patients use frequent use of artificial tears. In this case, if someone is having irritation, they're probably going to want to use a non-preserved artificial tear because you're going to probably be using that frequently, maybe every 1 to 2 hours, or even considering something thicker like a gel or an ointment. Eye doctors may also consider putting their patients on a prophylactic antibiotic eye drop or ointment. Yes, monkeypox is a virus, so antibiotics aren't going to do anything, but because of the potential for open ulcers on the eye, the doctor may want to give you an antibiotic to prevent possible bacterial superinfection. Now, one other treatment that doctors may consider prescribing, but it hasn't technically been shown to be proven effective for monkeypox specifically, but it has been effective for treating what's called vaccinia, which is again one of the same family members of pox viruses. And that is an eye drop called trifluridine, or under the brand name Viroptic, which is an eye drop that eye doctors often prescribe for something called herpes simplex virus. But unfortunately, that medication does have a preservative in it called thimerosal, which is a derivative of mercury, which causes a lot of irritation of the surface of the eye. So no matter what, it's good to be using artificial tears in those cases. Either way, it's important that both you and doctors recognize this and consider if treatment with topical antibiotics as a prophylaxis or even topical antiviral therapy would be needed. Now, I know myself and a lot of people are feeling probably a little bit shell-shocked just us getting over this wake of COVID and now we're having to address monkeypox, but please let me know your thoughts about monkeypox. Is it something you're concerned about at all? Is it something that you or a family member or somebody you know has had to struggle with? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Of course, and as always with medicine, things do change and evolve over time as new publications and research comes out, and I strongly encourage anybody experiencing any eye health related issue to talk with a local eye care professional about appropriate diagnosis and treatment. Now, if you do want to learn more about smart things to do if you get a case of pink eye or different eye drops that may work really well for the eye, check out our other videos coming up over here. Otherwise, again, this is Dr. Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.